So that could be extra scary. So when they stop and they go, oh, that's a scary noise. Let's try. They want to figure out what that noise was because it added extra scare. Go ahead and ask them to try. Change hands, but one hand's going to tell his nose what you want it to do, so you're going to have have, there you go. Tell his nose where you want his nose to go, and then you're going to tell him by touching his shoulder. There. Good. So now you have a way to communicate to him to go through those noodles. Bring him back. Yep. Tell him to follow his nose. Thank you. You want him to back through there. That's the first step. Okay. I did it, and I'm being rewarded, so it must be okay. Because the next thing you're going to have him do after he comes around that barrel is you're going to have him come in front of you. So as he, as his hip touches the, or comes around that barrel, you're going to invite him to you, then you're going to stand up and redirect him and tell him to go back through those barrels. You're going to try to make sure that your energy is very flowy and not kind of make it happen. Because we want him to believe that he's done what you're asking instead of, like, in a, like, a forced situation.
Thank you.
boy is responding to the rope. So what I want you to do is I want you to allow him to leave you. Okay? Because what happened was, you're doing the rope, you were getting in his face, constantly the rope. So what you just do is just kind of feed it out of your own feet and let him leave. So let's see if you can
Thank you.
fall to dive in right now, and then we're like, oh, we get to find out, you know? Oh, we did this.
Yeah, it's too windy.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me see what. Oh. that break anyway, right? Now I'm going to keep going. Which, okay, I gave you the break. Now you go. Good. Good. Up. Keep the tension. So instead of letting him pull you, you keep a hold of his nose and you ask him to air. Good. Now let me go.